Thank you. Good evening. I'm Will Schroeder. I'm the state senator for Campbell, Pendleton, and Bracken, and it is an honor to be here. But more importantly, it is great to sit up here and to look out at you all and to be in a church and talk about this topic and to see so many people here in this church. You know, as a Christian who's been blessed with the opportunity to be a state senator, sometimes it's very frustrating when I see people look to the government time and time again for the answers, when we know as Christians, the government's not the final answer. It's Jesus Christ and faith in God and His help. So now that you guys applauded, I'm just gonna stop talking. So I was asked to speak briefly on Senate Bill 192, and that was just passed this last session. And I was a co-sponsor of that bill and had a lot to say in it. One thing I'll start off by saying is my predecessor, Senator Katie Stein, for the two prior years had educated and discussed and tried to bring members of the General Assembly, bring their attention to this epidemic. And you know, third time was a charm, but without her work, I'm not sure if we would have had that success. Briefly, just some of the topics that bill did, the idea was to lay the groundwork at the state level, to lay the groundwork so the local communities could really have the tools in their toolbox to continue this fight. Some of the big things that stood out in the bill, one is just access to naloxone, Narcan, just getting that access to more people. You know, there's some concern, well, are we just giving a tool to users to just continue to think, oh, I have another way out? And while that, you know, is always gonna be a concern, as Jason Merrick says, you know, you can't offer treatment to someone who's overdosed and passed away from this. So I think ultimately that is a good thing to have more access to those individuals. There's trafficking provisions. You know, up here in Northern Kentucky, with Cincinnati right across the river, we see, and Steve can, you know, attest to how frustrating it is to see the trafficking from Ohio. So we try to address that. There's a Good Samaritan provision. Now, what the Good Samaritan provision is if two people are shooting up and one is overdosing, their friend can call 911, report the overdose, and not have to fear that they're going to, you know, be punished for that call, to fear that their friend is gonna, you know, be taken away to jail. Now, this is tough. It was a tough one when we debated this down there, because as Detective Bridger will tell you, a lot of times getting that person arrested, that starts the their opportunity to get them into treatment, where with this Good Samaritan provision, they're not going to be arrested. But again, the concern is, well, how many people are not going to call? And the studies in other states have seen that there's a real fear of calling when there's the fear that their friend is going to get arrested, and they might think, well, maybe they'll come out of it this time, they came out of it last time, so we'll just take that chance. And you know, we can't, it's people's lives, we can't afford them to take chances. So I think ultimately that was a good thing. The last thing Steve already talked about is needle exchange. And before I was a state senator, I was assistant commonwealth attorney, I was a prosecutor here in Campbell County. And before I really started researching this, you know, I didn't really think that made sense either. I thought, you know, why would we just give them a tool to shoot up? You know, that doesn't really make sense. But looking and educating myself about it, you know, this is an opportunity at the needle exchange for people to be introduced into different treatments, their potential path to treatment. A lot of these people, if they're not arrested, they might not have that knowledge, might not have that access. On a financial note, hepatitis C was mentioned. In 2014, the state of Kentucky, through Medicaid, spent $27 million on hepatitis C treatment. So when we're talking about, you know, we don't even have the funds as it is to cover what we need to cover, let alone continue to pay for hepatitis C, and it's only going to continue to get worse from what we continue to hear. So I'm happy to talk more later after this or in the questions about Senate Bill 192. One thing, a thought I wanted to leave everyone with is, you know, a lot of times if you read comments on NKY.com after there's a heroin story, or if you just talk to people, I'm sure you guys have experienced it like we've experienced it, a lot of people kind of have this who cares attitude. You know, maybe they think these people got themselves into this situation, and, you know, what are we going to do about it? You know, I think that when you look at the Bible and what Jesus says about leaving the flock of the 99 to go after the one, you know, that's how we as Christians, we have that obligation. And Jesus didn't say, you know, go ask that one what he was doing, how come he couldn't keep up with the 99? He got himself in that situation to begin with. He doesn't say that. He says, you know, the example of love is when you leave that 99 to go after that one. And I think we have that obligation. Thank you.